So there's this thing that they say that you can never walk through a door because you like go halfway through it, and then you go a fourth of the way through it, and then you go an eighth of the way through it, and then you go a sixteenth of the way through it. And if you keep going, basically what's gonna happen is you're gonna be like going like, I don't know, 1 to the 10,000 billionth. But you're still not actually gonna get through the door. Because you know there's always another half to go. Now in real life, of course, that's ridiculous because whenever I put that in, it's basically zero. And so the theory is, well, you know, at some point it gets small enough that you just walk through the door. So that's what we're going to kind of do with a while loop, is we're going to keep track of these terms, and then we're going to stop whenever the terms get to be sufficiently small. So I mean, it would be simple enough to get started. What we want to do is we want to start. So whenever you're starting a while loop, it's probably one of the hardest ones to start because you really got to have a plan of what you're doing and how you're going to get out of it before you get too far along. Whereas like with just regular coding or if statements, you can be like, well, I'll do half of the if statement, then I'll do the other half. With while loops and with fors, you know exactly how many times you're going to do something. But with the while loops, things are getting kind of weird. So one of the ways that I've gotten around it in the past, if I wasn't exactly sure how I wanted to do it, I start with a flag, just some random flag thing. And I'd say, while the flag was equal to one, and I know, you don't actually have to say while flag is equal to one, you could actually just say while flag, but I'm gonna say while flag is equal to one, do stuff. And then I'm gonna say if something or other, then I'm gonna set flag to zero. Okay, does that kind of make sense? So basically, I'm setting this up, and I can switch it from this to like a normal while loop in a minute, but this really kind of helps me in the initial planning stages to make sure that I'm doing everything right. Because for some reason, putting it in the while statement just kind of freaks me out initially. Well, it used to. I mean, but anyway, it's one of those things that it just kind of was a crutch that helped me get through initially. Okay, so basically, and if this doesn't make any sense, then you could come back and do this in a little bit, or do it the other way that we'll do in a minute. But basically the idea is I want to start off, I want to sum answers together. So since I'm going to be summing answers together, I'm always going to initialize it to zero, unless it some specific reason I need to do otherwise. But since I'm adding a bunch of stuff, I'm going to start with zero. So basically I want to keep adding and adding and adding and adding. Now, in order to do this, I have to keep track of this number that keeps changing over and over and over and over again. So the number goes 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, 1/16. So I kind of snuck the kitten out in front. I don't know what that means, but 1/2 to the 0 plus 1/2, well, not 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1st, 2 squared, 2 to the 3rd, 2 to the 4th, kind of that way. So basically whenever I'm doing this is I'm continually adding inverse powers of 2. So that's why I call this a while loop with indexing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with my first power, or my power thingy. And my power thingy is going to start off at 1. Okay, so whenever I do stuff, instead of just saying do stuff, I'm going to say, okay, well, my answer is going to equal to the current value of my answer, and you should be kind of used to doing that, plus 1/2 to the power thingy. So the first time it comes through, it'll be 2 to the 1. Now, the next thing I want to do is, next time I go through, I don't want to add 2 to the 1st, I want to add 2 to the 2nd, so I'm going to say power thingy equals power thingy plus 1. There's not a plus plus thing that you can do in MATLAB, so in case you're another kind of programmer, you can't do that, but that's okay. So basically now I want to increase that value by 1, okay? So let's just pretend that nothing else is going on here, no flags, no whatevers, and just kind of think about what's going to happen. So I have power thingy is 1, my answer is 0. Okay, and I'm going to assume that this is going to happen indefinitely because this flag is always going to be true because I haven't changed it yet. But so you get the idea of what's going on. So my answer is equal to 0. Oh, I put a plus. There we go. Sorry. Is 0 plus 1. I did it again. Plus 1/2 to the 1st. So it'd be 1/2 is 0.5. And then power thingy is going to be equal to power thingy plus 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. on the next iteration, my answer is going to be the current value of my answer, which is 0.5 plus 1 over 2 to the 2. And that's 0.5 plus 0.25, so that's 0.75. And my power thingy is going to be equal to the current value plus 1 or 3. All right, and so I can do it one more time just to get you, make sure you're kind of cool with what's going on. So current value of my answer plus 1 over 2 cubed. And I don't know what that is. 0.875, I probably could have figured that out. 0.875, and then power thingy is equal to current value of power thingy plus 1, which is 4. So basically you're just gonna keep getting closer and closer and closer and closer. Okay, now, I'm going to show you what happens if I never change the flag, and you should kind of know what this is going to be, but we'll run it anyway. I'll start with the CLC clear, and I go, choo! Oh, but I'm suppressing everything so you can't see. All right. Remember, you can always hit Control C to get out of stuff. So all I'm going to do is display my answer. And it got to one really fast. Okay, so even if I scroll up, let's see how far I can scroll up. As far as I can scroll up, it says it's one. Just get over yourself. Okay. So maybe I'll put a pause for a half a second. Okay, so now you can see that it's running and it's basically one, and now it's like just one. Okay, so you can see how quickly that happens. Control C. All right, so what we kind of do is we arbitrarily decide, well, I'm going to get so small that that maybe I just don't care anymore. Okay, and I don't want to keep going. So a lot of times what that's going to look like is I'm actually going to move this around. So I'm going to move this in this if statement into here. So basically what I'm going to say is if this new term is say less than, I don't know, so we'll say 10 to the negative 12. So I think it's less than 10 to the negative 12, just stop. Okay. So I want to do that before I increase the power thingy, just so that I have it, you know, I don't want to change it before I've compared it. So basically the idea that I could say is, okay, well, I can say if 1 over 2 to the power thingy, if that is less than 10 to the 12, then I can say I'm going to set flag equal to 0. Okay, so does that make sense? Because what's going to happen is flag is going to stay to be 1 until this term gets sufficiently small that no one's going to notice. So in fact, whenever that happens, I don't need to do this, but I'm going to display 1 over 2 to the power thingy so you can believe me, I guess. Now that I know we're making this a little bit more complicated than it needs to be, but I feel like I want to show you everything, and then we'll do it like this a couple of different ways. So here we go. Run this. Well, that was fast. You actually see that it does get down. Okay, so there's 0.5, 0.7, 0.75, and here we go, and it's zeros, and not zeros. It's basically ones. Okay, and then it says, okay, we're at 1, but that new term I was about to add, or new term that I just added, was 9 times 10 to the negative 13, so I stop. Okay, so there you go. So this is one way that you can do this, and this works, and it's beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to show you a couple of other ways that we could kind of organize this. So let's try to do it without a flag. Okay, so I'll just delete all this. So if I'm going to do this without a flag, let's see. So I'm going to say, I'm going to start up again with my answer is going to be 0. And I could say, I'm still going to need a power thingy starting off at 1. And I'm going to say, while something or other, I want to say my answer is equal to my answer plus 1 over 2 to the power thingy. And then I have to increase power thingy. Okay. So power thingy starts out as 1, and then I'm going to increase it and do this. So this is all I'm going to have in here. Now, what I could have in here is I could actually say while the new term 1 to the power thingy is greater than 10 to the 12, keep going. Okay, does that make sense? So while that thing is greater than 10 to the negative 12, while it's greater than, is that what I had up here? Yeah, 10 to the negative 12, okay. I could say, while this is greater than 10 to the negative 12, then keep going. You might say, well, technically, maybe this is gonna include one extra term that you didn't include before, and in my particular application, I deeply don't care, just because it was kind of an arbitrary decision. I could probably, you know, get away with, if I really cared, if I really wanted to get the exact same code that I had before, then I would say, let's see, I think I would just say this. Okay, but I think that's a lot more confusing to somebody who's trying to learn how to do while loops, honestly, if any of this isn't already bad enough already. So I'm just gonna leave it at this, and I'm gonna say, you know, you always wanna be really careful that your while loops are exactly what you wanna be, but since my epsilon, my teeny weeny number is kind of arbitrary, it's not that big of a deal. Other things it would be a big deal, but in this particular example, it's really not that big of a deal. But I'm gonna say while this 1/2 to the power thingy is sufficiently small, I wanna keep adding numbers. And if I do this, I'm still gonna get 1. Now, what I could do to compare the two is to see how big power thingy gets. So let me unsuppress power thingy here and I run it. So power thingy gets to 41. Here I run it and power thingy gets to, come here, 40. But the difference is that the difference? Oh, the difference is I don't actually run it. So let me list power thingy at the beginning of the while loop so you can see what actually happens. So power thingy and power thingy. Right. So here whenever I run it, power thingy, it does get up to 40, so I am off by 1. And here I'm at 39. So I could change this probably by adding a 1 here or starting different. But deeply, 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 it does not matter to me. So then the next thing that I wanted to do is I'd really like to keep track of what these terms are as I go. And one of the neat things is that power thingy is actually kind of like an index. Well, not kind of an index, it is an index. It's something that starts at 1 and it slowly increases over time. So really what I want to do is what I would like to do specifically is I'm going to just start keeping track of this new term on its own. So rather than doing that, I'm going to call something like my new term equal to do that. And then instead of doing that, I'll add new term like that. So I have pachonk, pachonk, and if I run it, everything still happens the way it always did, except that now nothing's different, basically, is what's going on. Now nothing has changed. Okay, but what I could do now is I could actually store this information into a matrix or an array. So I could say all my terms at position, and then here's the question is what position? Well, the first time I go through, I want to store at position 1, and the second time position 2, et cetera, et cetera. Well, the good news is that power thingy already does that for me. The first time it runs through, it's equal to 1. The second time it runs through, it's equal to 2, so on and so forth. So basically what I want to do is I want to keep track of all the new terms that I'm going to add, and then I'm going to add it, and then I'm going to increase power thingy. So basically what happens is I define a new term, I'm going to store it and add it to my answer, and then I'm going to increase power thingy, and I will break if this term gets to be sufficiently large. Okay, so let's see what happens when I run this. Nothing. Well, stuff happens, but you can't see it. So let me come down here. I'm going to display all my terms. Awesome. So you can see I have 40 terms, which makes sense because that's when I said things break down. And I can even change this up here if I want to have less terms. So I could just say it gets to be that small. And I have 19 terms. But I can basically, what's cool about this is I can actually see what these terms are. And I actually want to display it transpose a little bit. No, not like that. So there, so you can see the half, the basically powers of 2. I can format. Is that long? Yeah. Okay, there we go. So there I can see my 0.5, 0.25, and these terms continually get smaller and smaller. So what's cool about kind of having this indexing ability within the while loop is that I can see I can see things changing over time, especially if I'm storing them into a matrix, but then I can stop making the matrix whenever I have met a certain condition. And the power series kind of seems like a pretty decent way to do that.